Good morning. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thanks. Happy Valentine's
Day. Hi. Happy Valentine's Day to you. You have big plans today?
Yeah.
Oh, good.
She's really good. She's been with the county. She's coming over from the sheriff's office, and she actually worked in HR and before risk management was separated from HR. We worked together, so she's very familiar with what we do in risk management, and she's really good. So,
was that a recent separation of HR and risk management?
We've actually probably been separated since 2009.
Okay.
So we've been our own department for a little while. So it's exciting to be able to have the opportunity to establish a department. I mean, because we didn't have a risk management department, we were kind of in HR, and so I had the opportunity to come out and build our own departments, our own processes, and it's been good. It's been good for the county. I mean, we've been able to really save a lot of money on insurance premiums and losses, and it just helps, I think, to have a clearer focus on safety and loss control.
So many employees and properties and buildings are still on
the show. It is. It is. It's a lot to keep up with, and we started out at one point it was just me, and then we pulled out workers' comp
from HR and put it with risk management. So then I got another staff, so it was two. And then last year, they granted us one more position. So then we now we're a department of three. But right now, with Amber leaving, and then I, one of my staff members is on leave, so it's me
for another week. So it's been fun. I've been having fun these last week.
So,
are you the head of the
department? Good morning.
I am.
Good morning, Ms. Smith.
Good morning.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
How are you?
I'm good, Jim.
I'm good, thank you.
You okay?
I'm doing good.
How are
you?
So far.
I feel good.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good.
How are you?
They're doing just fine. Thank you. I appreciate you asking. I told them before we
get
to
medicine.
You get to swim in life, you start this week. Send the best regards to us.
Happy Valentine's Day.
You should have admiration.
I appreciate that. Yes, speak very highly of you.
Well, thank you.
Good morning.
Good morning, Mr.
Perry.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
Doing great. Thank you.
Good morning.
How are you?
Good. You want to copy of the agenda?
Sure.
It's a happy one, too.
Good to see you. Good morning. Happy Valentine's Day.
Yeah,
I'm sorry.
What did you do to your arm?
I was snowboarding. I dislocated my elbow.
Oh. It's a dangerous one.
Yeah.
You and Dr. Howell don't feel left out. I wish you a happy Valentine's
Day. I just had a Valentine's Day. I still remember Christmas Day, Valentine's Day.
I bet Miss Howell remembers it.
I
told him
he brought
it down.
Yeah.
Well, Mama has that trouble too. You're on our priors, I hope.
Well,
you know.
Thank you. Thank you.
I know.
I got to work there. I already talked to them. I had enough air. Dr. Morning asked me last week, he said, you can improve on that. I said, well, you can find worse shape than you felt.
What time is it when you got out?
At 9:59.
That's what I
county time.
Greenwich Mean Time.
It's something. Oh, now at 10.
Mm-hmm.
I said it just hit 10.
It did.
Yeah.
Our clerk says it's 10 o'clock, and so. On the record.
You are.
We'll call Civil Service Board's monthly meeting to order. Today's date is Thursday, February the 14th, 2013. Members present are Dr. Howell, our Vice Chairman, Mr. Tim Deary, a member of the Civil Service Board, Ms. Clerk, our Clerk, Deary Smith, the Chairman. We have a quorum, so I call the meeting to order. Gentlemen, do I hear a motion to adopt the agenda?
So moved.
I second motion.
Motion and a second to adopt the agenda. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. The motion passes unanimously. Have you had a chance to read the minutes?
I have, Mr. Chairman. I cannot find anything out of place.
That's good. That's a good part. I hear a motion to adopt the minutes.
I'll make that motion then.
Second.
Motion and a second to adopt the minutes from their last meeting. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries unanimously. Items for consideration for today's meeting. Ms. Clark, can you bring us up to date on the John Gooch case?
There are no updates to report, Mr. Chairman.
Okay. Item two, resignation of our counselor and hearing officer. Would you like to address that?
Sure, Mr. Chairman. I believe to put on the record, I received as clerk on behalf of the board a letter directed to
Mr. Smith, Dr. Howell, Mr. Perry from Mr. Dana Miles, our hearing officer. And it states, it is with regret I must submit this letter as my formal resignation as the hearing officer and general counsel for the Forsyth County Civil Service Board, effective February 1st, 2013. Our firm has been asked to and agreed to serve as the attorney for the Forsyth County Sheriff. This creates a potential conflict of interest, which unfortunately precludes me from continuing to be the hearing officer and general counsel for the Civil Service Board. It's been a pleasure working with each of you and serving as board counsel and hearing officer for the past 12 years. Thank you for giving me that opportunity. With kindest regards, I remain Dana Miles.
Kidoki.
Serious love for that.
Yes. Serious yes. Love. I don't think we have to have a motion to accept that resignation, but we will put it in our minutes.
I would say you could. I think out of an abundance of caution, you may just want to make a motion and a second to accept it.
Do I hear a motion to accept Mr. Miles' resignation?
I shall move, Mr. Chairman.
Second.
Motion and a second to accept his resignation. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries unanimously. At some point in time at the next meeting or sometime, we'll do a resolution for him and for his 12 years of service. He's done an outstanding job. I think that he's saved the county a lot of money and probably potential lawsuits or at least appeals from some of the decisions we've rendered. So we'll miss him. He's done a good job. Item number three is directly related to that. Gentlemen, do you have any suggestions on who we might get to be our counsel, board counsel, and hearing officer for our hearings?
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to say just a couple things, if I may. First of all, we're going to miss Dana. Certainly, he's been a source of strength for this board and entire county for many years. And he will be missed, and I'm sure Dana will do well in whatever he does. He's a good friend, and we'll miss him, but nevertheless, we've got to hire a legal counsel to represent us and serves in the capacity of hearing officer. I've given it quite a bit of consideration. There are a lot of good attorneys here in Forsyth County. We're going to need someone that has a litigation background, someone experienced. I would like to discuss hiring Rich Neville. Rich certainly has a background in litigation. He has worked for a reputable firm for many years. Aside from his professional qualifications, I think Rich is a man of integrity, and I hold him in high regard. He's a good family man. I think he would represent the Civil Service Board well, and I would like to put that, if I may, I would like to put that in the form of a motion that we hire Rich Neville as our legal counsel as well as our hearing officer.
Can we wait just a minute and see what Dr. Howell has? Do you have any thoughts, Dr. Howell?
Well, I'm going to recommend the same thing you did.
Well, that's good then.
I talked to Dan, everybody I talked to mentioned it. Like I say, most time we find in real estate, we'll find men that, you know, me and Lars and Joe, we found out that know anything about civil service law until they sit here at the future. And Mr. Smith has made some good lawyers as far as this type of litigation. He's told a lot of folks, good lawyer. He has led many, actually, many folks along who are not too confident, very confident. Mr. Smith is one of my favorites. I do regret that we're losing Dana Miles, but he has been a wonderful person to work with. Always dependable in what he says he means. And I'm sure he's not a native of Georgia.
But he's a citizen now.
Oh, sure. You know, that was my thinking. I was going to do the same thing he just did, Mr. Baker. Now, I would ask you this question. Is this going to be a full-time business? I don't know. Will it be a trial basis or a couple of months?
Well, I think that my opinion is that if he will accept it, we'll get him on board and he'll be on trial for us. We may not be on trial for him, but we'll see how it works out. I don't think that we'll really know how he's going to handle things until we have a hearing. If we don't ever have a hearing, you know, there's not a whole lot to it just to keep us out of trouble, so.
Let me ask another question, Mr. Do we have a second hearing actually?
We had one appeal, but if you remember, it was one of the, it was a 8-hour suspension, so it went through the, just the review process versus a full hearing. It was the submitting the documentation and having the opportunity to review.
That's going to be unusual here.
Yes.
You never saw it.
And you know that, of course, the county mandated the review the way that we handled it, but it's very difficult on us because we can't ask questions. It's a lot more difficult to do. So, with that being said, Mr. Perry, I'll entertain your motion that you want to make it again.
I would move that we hire Rich Neville as our legal counsel as well as the hearing officer for the Civil Service Board.
I second the motion.
All in favor of the motion to hire Mr. Rich Neville to represent the board as our counsel and hearing officer, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries unanimously. Ms. Clerk, would you get a letter and off to him and ask him, you know, that the board has chosen him, if he would be willing to accept it?
Sure.
And I guess that you will expedite if he accepts his approval with the Board of Commissioners.
I will.
We need to get him on board by the time, at least by the next meeting, and of course if this Mr. Gooch case comes up, we'll need somebody to handle that. So
sure.
If you'll do that.
I will. I'll reach out to him today.
Okay. In fact, you might call him. He's with Neville and Cannot. And if you speak to him on the phone and tell him what done, and then you can get the letter and the follow-up. But if he says he's agreeable to it, then you know you could start that procedure with the Board of Commissioners.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Gentlemen, I see no need to go into executive session today. Is there anything else that needs to come before the board? If not, do I hear a motion to adjourn?
I make the motion to adjourn, Mr. Chairman.
Second.
Motion and a second to adjourn. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries unanimously. Until the next meeting will be on, when will the next meeting be?
Thursday, March 14th, 2013.
Okay. Thank y'all.
Thank you.
Miss Howell can come in here, you know.
She went to say which one.
She did? Where's she at? It's warm. I can't find
one of the front rooms right across from the entrance.
Oh, okay. I didn't see her when I came in.
She went to send a car.
Ice cake is ready to sit in the car. Yeah. I think it's $3.50 and
all the stuff is kind of expensive. Yeah. Hope your arm gets better. How long do I have to keep it in that thing? I don't really have to. It just protects it. So. It happened 2.5 weeks ago, so. Getting better.
Yeah,
no snowboarding for a while, though, right?
Where were you?
North Carolina, up in Maggie Valley.
Were you skiing or what?
Snowboarding. I got hit by a skier.
Oh.
Hit my legs and I fell off my arm.
You can get killed on skis real fast.
I know.
If you don't kill yourself, somebody else can do it. That's a rapid.
Yeah.
It's dangerous.
I've been plenty of times, so I figured I know how to take care of myself.
Yeah, plenty of time to meditate on. That's right. Good to see you. Appreciate you getting me.
Yeah, I know. I think I missed last month. We called charity and tried to catch up. So.
The county's at peace.
Okay, have a good day.
Bye-bye.
Like a church. Peace is a wonderful thing. Gentlemen, good to see you.
I know it's good to see you. Is your mom doing any better?
Mom's doing pretty good, Dr. Howell. So she's been in.
Y'all have a great day.
Okay, see
you. Thank you.
You too.
Bye.
She.
I'll be speaking.
Yeah. Thank you, clearly.
Dr.
Ryan.
Good to see you again.
Always good to see you again. I'm angry.
What's your hat?
Thank you. Good to see you. Hope all goes well and you have a good Valentine's. See you.
Yes, sir. Jim Fagan and I left Regions Bank 16 years ago.
Yes, sir.
That's right.
Well, you've done well. I'm happy for you.
Thank you.
Ms. Tisdale, have a good day, ma'am.
Thank you. You too, as well.
Bye.
Dr. Howell, bye-bye.